It's 2:01 p.m. I'm just taking another look here and see what... Ace is still pushed back. Starting to move in a little bit closer. Over there it's getting thicker. And you can see for the most part, above us though, we got blue skies. And I think cumulus clouds. Alright, so it obviously looks like they stopped. Thought it was a useless decision to continue to spray over the house. What they probably did was went up there. That's why it's probably thickening up. It's because they probably went up there a good ways and just hammered it out. That's what they'll do when it won't stick over top. They'll just go upwind and hammer it out real bad. I've seen it on a couple occasions when we were up that way doing jobs. Them just X-ing it a million, like laying the X's so close together too, it's just, it's sickening. There you go, I figured I'd just give you a look at 2:00 p.m. now. Anybody watching this that has more knowledge than me, please explain to me sine waves and square waves and why we should use square wave circuits in powered organite devices, or when you're wrapping a coil around a crystal and you want to pulse frequency through it. Why do we use the square wave? Why is it better? Everyone swears that that's what you should use. Other people say that that's the what they're using is square wave, and I don't know. I get results both ways, it seems. Sometimes sine wave doesn't work out, but like it, square wave is better in my opinion. If someone can clear that up. I know the frequencies of the Earth are all sine waves, you know, natural flowing frequencies, but you know, I don't know. Either way, we got some clearing results. Yeah. Peeping the scene.